So, good morning, friends. Today's topic is the working of NOx sensors and how the NOx sensor works while the operation of the engine, and how the knocking is produced in the engine. That we will see in the today's lecture. Okay. Now, in this, the figure shows the piston and cylinder assemblies in which the piston is moving from BDC to 2DC in the power stroke. Okay, now this is the diagram where the piston is moving from BDC to TDC in the power stroke. Okay, and this is crank, this is piston, cylinder, this is spark plug. Okay, this is the bottom dead center and this is the top dead center. Okay, so what happened when the piston moves from BDC to TDC, that is from bottom dead center to top dead center. Okay, that is the few degree before TDC. Let us see this point, and this is a point where piston reaches to the top dead center here. Okay, and this is the connecting rod, which is few degree before TDC. Okay, now when the piston is few degree before TDC, what happened? Spark is injected into the combustion chamber, and when the spark is injected into combustion chamber, it will ignite the charge. Okay, and charge will ignite in the progressive wavefront like this. Okay, that the wavefront will of ignition will start from the tip of spark plug, and it will propagate likewise like this. Okay, and so when the piston is just before the TDC, we introduce the spark. Okay, and it's due to the spark, the charge waves are going to propagate like this. And in this diagram here, what we will see, when the piston is at the top dead center, just at the TDC, okay, the wavefront in the clearance volume, this is a clearance volume, this is almost propagated. In the combustion chamber. Okay, and in the third diagram, what we will see, when the piston crosses the top dead center, that is the piston reaches the top dead center and just began to move downward, that is it will cross 2 to 3 degree after TDC like this. Look at this point. Okay, this is the TDC point, and this is the point where it crosses 2 to 3 degree from TDC. That is, piston is just moving in the, just start to moving in the downward direction. Okay, now in this case, when the piston is just start to moving in the downward direction, the charge available in the clearance volume produces the maximum pressure on the piston. Okay, this is very important. The maximum pressure is attained on the piston when the piston is just in the position to move in the downward direction. Okay, ideally the maximum pressure should attain in this conditions, when the piston is just moving downward. Okay, so when the piston is just moving downward and there is a maximum pressure, all the pressure will exerted on the crown of the piston, and piston will vigorously move down, due to which the crank will rotate in the clockwise direction. Okay, so this is the ideal combustion process. But what happened in the knocking? This particular condition, that is attainment of the maximum pressure, is attained when the piston is at TDC, not when the piston is moving downward. That is not in this third condition. In third condition, what happened? Piston is already crosses the TDC, that is it is just began to move in the downward direction. And in the case of knocking, the piston is at the TDC. Okay, that is when the piston is at TDC, what happened? Maximum pressure is attained. Okay, the when maximum pressure is attained and the piston is just at TDC, okay, in that case piston maximum pressure will act on the piston, but piston will not move in the downward direction. Okay, because when the piston is moving in the downward direction in the straight ahead position, there is a reaction, upward reaction from the crankshaft. Okay, the crankshaft gives a upward reaction with the help of connecting rod, this is in the upward direction, and this maximum pressure created on the piston moves in the downward direction. Okay, due to which there is a cancellation of the upward and downward force in this case. Okay. At the same time, if the maximum pressure is attained in this particular case, for when the piston is when the piston doesn't reach at TDC, okay, or the piston is trying to reach at TDC or before TDC, what happens if the maximum pressure is attained in this case and piston is moving in the upward direction and maximum pressure produced by the burning of charge pushes the piston in a downward direction. Okay, in this case also there is a chances of knocking, because what happened, piston moves in the upward direction, that is towards TDC, and charge for pressure pushes the piston in a downward direction, due to which there is a tendency of knocking in the combustion chamber. Okay, now this is the diagram in the combustion chamber where the knocking takes place. Okay, that is maximum pressure is attained just at the TDC or before TDC, piston is moving before TDC, okay, or just at the TDC. In this diagram the piston is just at TDC and maximum pressure is attained when the piston is at TDC. Okay, in this case what happened, the reaction force is moving in the upward direction and the pressure applied on the piston is moving in the downward direction. Okay, so due to which what happened, the pressure wave created by this spark plug, okay, as shown in this figure, that is here the pressure wave is propagated like this. Okay, and when this pressure wave collides with the top crown of the piston, it will rebound back as shown in figure. Okay, now there are two pressure waves, one is propagating towards rightward and one is propagating towards leftward. Okay, now these two propagating waves collides with each other, and due to this collision what happened, as the frequency of these two waves are almost same, there is a resonance occur in this combustion chamber, and due to this resonance knocking sound is produced in the combustion chamber. Okay, so the intensity of this the intensity of pressure during this knocking is very very high, due to which what happened, due to this knocking it may also damage the crown of the piston. Okay, it may also damage the cylinder head, cylinder valves. Okay, and sometimes it also break the piston. Okay, so it is a very high intensity knocking due to the collision of these two pressure waves. Okay, so this knocking should be always avoided in the IC engine. Okay, now as I discussed earlier, in this case what happened, the peak pressure should attend when the piston process the TDC. Okay, when the piston crosses TDC and just start to move in the downward direction, that is the maximum pressure should attend when the piston moves 2 to 3 degree after TDC. Okay, when it attend TDC and it moves 2 to 3 degree after TDC, here the maximum pressure should act on the piston. Okay, but in certain case what happened, maximum pressure acts when the piston is TDC or before it going to TDC, that is in this condition or this condition the maximum pressure occurs. Okay, when the maximum pressure occur in these two conditions, what happened, knocking will occurs. Okay, so this is due to the wrong ignition timing, the knocking will occur. Okay, so we have to adjust the ignition timing so that we will subsidize the knocking. So this is the first reason of knocking in the engine, that is the wrong ignition timing. The second reason is due to the pre-ignition. Okay, what happened in the pre-ignition case, what happened if this is a tip of the spark plug, okay, and the temperature of the combustion chamber is very very high. Okay, so for example the engine is running with the full load and with the very high RPM. Okay, in this case what happened, the temperature of the combustion chamber become very very high, and due to this what happened, due to the high combustion high temperature of the combustion chamber, the tip of the spark plug become red hot. At the same time, if there is a poor quality of casting of the cylinder head, what happened, and if there is a projection left in the casting of the cylinder, what happened, that projection point the tip of the projection become red hot. Okay, and when this tip of the projection or the tip of the spark plug become red hot, and in this case when the tip become red hot and the piston is moving towards from BDC to TDC as shown in this figure, okay, so before the injection of spark by the ignition coil into the combustion chamber, the charge get ignited due to this red hot tip. Okay, that is much before the recommended timing. Okay, the charge will be much ignited much before the recommended timing, much before the spark plug. That is when the piston is suppose the piston is moving from BDC to TDC, ideally the combustion should takes place when the piston is just crosses the just 1 or 2 degree before TDC. But what happened in the pre-ignition case, the combustion of charge will takes place when the piston is in between TDC to BDC, okay, and due to which the maximum pressure wave is generated when and the piston is before TDC. That is, in this case piston is just in between BDC to TDC. Here only the maximum pressure will occur in the combustion chamber, due to which the combustion charge will push the piston in the downward, and the rotational momentum of the crank will pushes the piston in the upward direction, due to which there is a cancellation of forces of the upward force and downward force. Okay, there is a collision of wave fronts as shown in this figure. There is a collision of wave front, okay, and there is a knocking takes place. So pre-ignition is also avoided. Due to pre-ignition, there is also possibility of knocking. Okay, now to avoid knocking, modern IC engine has a device called as a knock sensor. This is a sensor, this is directly attached to the outer surface of the head, cylinder head, like this. It is bolted to the outer surface of the cylinder head, okay, and the working of this knock sensor, we will discuss the working of the knock sensor now. Now this is the diagram of the knock sensor, in which there is a bolt, okay, threaded bolt like this. This bolt is directly bolted to the cylinder head, okay, tightly, okay. This is the body of the knock sensor, okay, and this bolt is attached to the seismic mass like this. This is the seismic mass, okay, and after the seismic mass, the this is connected to the piezoelectric metal ring. This is the piezoelectric metal ring and this is the piezoelectric crystal, okay. So and this output of this piezoelectric crystal is connected to the engine control unit, okay, or CDI ignition system, okay. So how it works, so the working is like this. So whenever there is a knocking inside the engine, there is abnormal vibrations due to the collision of the two pressure waves. So when the two pressure wave collide, it will form a resonance, and due to the resonance, a abnormal rise in pressure in the combustion chamber takes place, okay. That means the engine will vibrate vigorously. So this vibration will transmitted to this bolt, okay. This vibration is transmitted through this bolt, and it is passes through this seismic material, and from seismic material it is passes through the piezoelectric crystal, okay. Now piezoelectric crystal has a property, so that whenever there is a longitudinal force along the certain axis of the piezoelectric crystal, okay, so what happened, this piezoelectric crystal convert that vibration motion along the certain axis, that is generator converts this vibration motion into the electric pulse, just like this. That is, these vibration motions in the upward and downward direction, which is acted on the generator of the piezoelectric crystal, is converted into this electric pulse like this, okay. This happens when there is a vibrations occurs or senses by or transmitted by this bolt. When this bolt transmit vibrations, it will sensed by this piezoelectric crystal and converted a signal. Okay, this generated signal is then transmitted to the digital CDI ignition system or ECU in the modern engine. Okay, and once this signal is generated and when it is transmitted to CDI ignition system, this CDI ignition system retards the ignition timing of the engine. Okay, and once this pulse is generated and this is given to CDI ignition system, CDI ignition system retards the ignition timing so that the maximum pressure will occur in this case, third case, that is when the piston is just crosses the top dead center and just start to move in the downward direction, that is 2 to 3 degree after attaining the TDC. Okay, so the CDI ignition system or engine control ECU always maintain this ignition timing just after the TDC at this range. Maximum pressure should occur in this range before passing of crankshaft to the or piston up to the TDC. Okay, that is maximum pressure occurs when the piston moves in just in the downward direction. So this timing is maintained by ECU. Okay, so whenever there is a knock, or whenever there is a due to knocking, and whenever there is a formation of pulse like this, the CDI ignition system or digital ignition system suddenly retard the ignition timing and make the ignition timing in this case 3 zone. Okay, it is after TDC, so that the knocking phenomena will avoided, or it subsidize the knocking. Okay, so this is how the knock sensor works. Okay, hope you understand this. If you have any problem, please comment on this topic. Thank you.